Friends, good morning. I reiterate the warm welcome that Dr. Kunte has extended to all of you, and on behalf of the Dr. Ashok Dharaniri Memorial Trust, I want to express my deep sense of gratitude to the speakers, to Dr. Ashutosh Poddar, and all of you delegates for enthusiastically participating in this very important seminar. The trust that Dr. Kunte referred to, Dr. Ashok Dharaniri Memorial Trust, actually owes its inception to sadness, to actually the pain of loss. Dr. Ashok Dharaniri, as most of you are aware, and some of you may have had the privilege of having known him, perhaps having interacted with him, and the rest of you may be aware at least of him. He was a giant. He was truly, as Chaitanya referred to, a scholar in everything that he got involved in. And his primary three loves of his life, I mean, apart from Mrs. Dharaniri, of course, were music, theatre, and literature. Okay. And then, of course, all performing arts and everything to do with culture and artistic expression, he was deeply immersed with. But these were the three primary loves of his life which really drove him. He has done stellar work in each one of them. If you look at the humongous volume of writing that he left behind in his works, I mean, there are articles, essays, interviews, various treatises, monographs, and of course 23 books. Prolific person, working right until the end, until death, in this most untimely and in a most tragic way, snatched him away. In a matter of months, it escalated, and in front of our eyes he just sort of disappeared. I mean, this huge monument of a personality just disappeared quite like that, and that void is still felt by us. So the trust was formed keeping in mind that had he really been around, I mean, it's a sentimental motivation, but had he really been around, there is so much more that would have happened in these three fields, purely owing to his contribution, owing to his initiative and scholastic leadership. So we decided, the four of us, I mean, there's Dr. Anish Pradhan, who's also been a student of his. In fact, Dr. Dharaniri was his guide for his thesis. Dr. Chaitanya Kunte, who has sort of really been, apart from a student, he's been a very fond person, Chaitanya and his wife Shruti. And they're like the true Dr. Dharaniri loyalists. And myself, owing to a family connection, because he happened to be my uncle. And another gentleman who Dr. Dharaniri was very fond of. So we formed this trust essentially to take forward his work. And this is also where I would like to inform you that it's a very ambitious program that the trust has. Right from organizing this memorial lecture, which we do every year on the 25th of November in Bombay at Nehru Center, to seminars and colloquiums and conferences like this, to scholarships, fellowships, other research projects that we'd like to encourage, and generally any kind of work that should be done in the field of arts in general and education. Dr. Dharaniri would have encouraged that, and the trust is here to do that. For more information about the trust, there is a website which you can reach, and of course Dr. Kunte is here with his archives, where all the information about what the trust does and where is it that the trust could possibly even support your initiatives, your wishes, your aims in these fields, you can most certainly interact with him, and we would be very happy to respond to that in as positive a way as we can. So once again, truly thank you very much, and it's a source of deep pleasure to participate in this, and to look forward to some really interesting debates, discussions, discourses here. And without further ado, let me please pass it on to our curator and the person who's actually organized this seminar for us, conference for us, Dr. Ashutosh Poddar. Please. Thank you very much.
थैंक यू अंजुम भाई. चैतन्य एंड ऑल्सो रानडे आर्काइव स्टाफ, श्रुति, वेदांत हैज बीन कोऑर्डिनेटिंग दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस. थिएटर आर्टिस्ट, इंथुजियास्ट, स्कॉलर्स, टीचर्स एंड ऑल द पीपल हु हैव कम फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र, आउटसाइड महाराष्ट्र, फ्रॉम डिफरेंट डिसिप्लिन्स एंड डिफरेंट प्रैक्टिसेस. एक्चुअली इट्स एन ऑनर एंड आई एम थैंकफुल टू द ट्रस्ट. इट्स वेरी वॉट यू कॉल ऑनर इन अ सेंस. आई एम कनेक्टिंग माई सेल्फ विद द वर्क दैट रानडे साहब हैज डन इन हिज लाइफ एंड आई हैवंट सीन हिम बट आई हैव रेड हिज वर्क. And on the first day when Anish called me to tell me this, ki, would you like to do this this conference? Because Ranade Saab had explored the idea of narration in theatre or narrative practices and theatrical practices. And when he asked me, would you like to do that? I said, yes, why not? And then, as a part of my own scholarship, as a part of my research work, I have been reading Ranade Saab's work and other works also that is part of narrative practices and theatrical practices. I was kind of, you know, the kind of work, huge work that Ranade Saab has done. So at some point, you know, you want to also give justice to that kind of work that he has done. And we have tried hard to do that. So it's been very, very wonderful experience of working with the trust and trustees of this Ashokdar Ranade Memorial Trust, because it's also been conceptually working on the concept note itself. So it's not only my contribution, it's also about the trust responding to this concept, and Anjum Bhai and Anish and Chaitanya and Mr. D'Souza. So yeah, so I'm very thankful to them, and also I welcome you on behalf of the trust. For me, the starting point while conceptualizing this whole idea was, the book called Katha Shatabdi that Ranade Saab had edited along with Vijaya Rajyadhyaksh. He did this book in 1993. And actually this book was a result of conference like this on narration and narrative that took place on 9, 10 and 11 December 1991 in Bombay. It was part of NCPA's work. This conference was attended by several renowned practitioners and scholars of the time. And they talked about diverse practices of storytelling or narration in all forms of art. So this was a kind of starting point for me to conceptualize this conference. So in a sense, you know, there is a kind of very interesting connect that I would like to bring in here, connect with Ranade Saab's work, also connect with this kind of event that was organized for 3 days in Bombay at that time. And after 27 years, we are connecting to that event again, and that's a very different coincidence, or what you call very different kind of happiness that I have today. One of the things that when I spoke with Professor Anish Pradhan was that it's not just idea of, you know, adding into what Ranade Saab has done, but also extending it further from where he has taken ahead. So the proposed conference is what we are interested in, not just focusing on the theatre per se, but also different traditions that are there in theatre itself. So we'll start with folk theatrical traditions, but also we'll go on to talk about contemporary practices, theatre for young, architectural practices, designing practices, directorial practices, and so on. So the proposed conference is interested in presenting nuanced understanding of interrelated and interdisciplinary concepts and practices of narration and performance in Indian context, addressing intersection of research and rehearsal processes, presentation of a performance, engagement with audience or society, and different theoretical perspectives. We plan to highlight historical and contemporary understanding of narrative and performance practices in India. That's what the broad focus of this conference is. Now, there are three key conceptual areas that we would like to address through this conference. One is this key, Narration is a process, and this process can be seen across different forms, different expressions. It's not just only in theater. Narration could be seen in different practices, different expressions. But what we are going to do for today's conference, that we are going to focus on theatrical practices. It's not just about, when I say theatrical practices, it's not just about performance or the show, but it's also about the process. How one gets into the process of creating a theater piece, and how one gets into the process of involving narrative within the theater itself. So on one hand, we are looking at the kind of outcome of the theatrical practice, but also we are looking at the process of involving narrative practices within the theater itself. So there is a bakhar, there is akhyan, there is kirtan, there are different kind of jalsas. If you look at context in Maharashtra, there are Satyashodhak jalsas, Ambedkari jalsas. Also there are different storytelling forms of, say, for example, talamadale kind of forms, or dastangoi, there are neatly structured plays performed within the proscenium, or street plays, dance drama, choreographic practices, or multimedia performances. So there is a vast kind of scope of what I call theatrical performance. Now the cross boundaries of a form are manifest into so many different ways. Ranade Sahab has written about it in his book. He says, a statement can turn into a narration. A narration can turn into a dialogue. A felt and specific emotion into an evocative mood because of the initial movement away from pure language use. In other words, a combination of the narrative and performing arts shifts and lifts the problem to an aesthetic plane where two arts and not two activities are engaged. And that's where I'm sharing with you another conceptual framework for this concept, note for this conference. So what we are looking at, we are not looking at two events, two activities, but we are looking at two aesthetic planes that could be explored through narrative practices and theatrical practices. So narration and theater, they are not just events, they are not just activities, but they are what you call they are aesthetic planes, as Ranade Sahab mentions. So they can't be considered separately, as narrative could be also some kind of performance, and performance can also be some kind of narrative. In his words, I again quote him, problems of their classification, which finally leads to the most fundamental parallelogram of forces that govern creation, the communication and reception of aesthetic endeavors. And that's where the third conceptual framework for this conference comes. When we started conceptualizing this whole idea of narration theater, what I realized is that there is also kind of classification issue here. So what we tend to do is that we tend to differentiate these two as different categories. And that's where Ranade Sahab has also kind of focused on. So these are not different classification. These are not different categories, because they also intersect into each other. So on one hand, there is a problem when we say narration in theater, but also on the other hand, it also opens up. And that's where the third thing is, that we would like, through the conference, we would like to also address this kind of classification issue, problem. It's a more kind of aesthetic problem. It's a more kind of conceptual problem. So maybe some of us would like to respond to not narration and theater as something very different. You may also want to challenge this idea itself and also see how they can be mixed together. And that's where I come to the third point, and that's third anchoring principle for this conference. When we say narration, there is a kind of storytelling form that we expect. So there is a story and that is to be told. But the question is, if there is no story, what do you do? If there is no story to tell, what do you do? And that's where I think also conference would like to address. If a theater practitioner, if a director, if a light designer, if a sound designer wants to tell not story but narrate something, if someone wants to just create scenes instead of saying that ki, I'm telling a story. So if you don't have the story to tell, if you don't have any beginning, middle and end to kind of share, so what do you do with the narration? That's where also Ranade Saab has also hinted on this issue. If there is no story, if there is a non-story form, so that the thing is that ki, even if there are no story, there are narrations. And so narrations could be anywhere. And that's where the last point of what you call anchoring principle for this conference, that's why we have invited light designers, one who works with the space, one who works with the technical, so-called technical aspects of theater. So what if an architectural space design that wants to, intends to tell a story, which is not story in itself, but narration itself is a narrative, and this becomes quite complex, and you will see some of our presenters they are also going to address this complexity within the narrative. Now coming back to the last point, so the point is that the narrative is not just about the structure, it's not just about craft. How do we address in contemporary time, how do we address the emerging political narratives through our theatrical practices? So you could see that there are a number of multimedia platforms, social media platforms, they are emerging and they are telling you, they are sharing certain narratives. And how does a theatrical practice, or how do different practices within theater respond to this changing social and political scenario in India? And what is the role of what you call changing narratives when it comes to the theater? So within the broad spectrum of narration and performance, we plan to address some of the concerns such as, how do we begin to look at narrativity and performativity? Innumerable stories are being told or performed in several ways. Multifold relations between narrator, performer, narrative, audience recreate the universe of complex relations and social cultural dynamic within a space. But what if there are no stories to tell, but a narrative or a series of events to perform? How do we understand narrative principle in a performance of events or happenings? How does an artist or group explore formal possibilities in telling stories, presenting narratives and performing actions? What are ways in which narrativized performance and perform narrative that can be analyzed? So these are some of the questions that I'm just sharing with you. So this is overall what I wanted to share, the kind of model that we are looking for this conference, that we are looking at very kind of informal, but though the setup is quite formal, so at some point we are going to break because this audience is a mix of artists and researchers. So Anubha, when I called her, she asked me, thi, Ashutosh, mujhe ye baat, ye mat batao ki mujhe bolna hai, bhashan karna hai. So, main bhashan nahi kar sakti hu, main baat kar sakti hu. So I said, okay, baat to karo. So our attempt is that ki, I didn't want to, when I started talking to people, ki Atul, Anubha, Sharmista, all of them are there. So when I started sharing with them, this is what we are planning to look at. So, are yaar, ye baat karo, ye conference, ye academic seminars, bahut hote, bahut, bahut satate, itna der baitna, ye karna, baate karna. So, I said, okay, we'll see how we can break this whole thing and how we can do baate. So the point here is this ki actually ye bhi salo 27 saal pehle Ranade saab ne kiya tha, Vijaya Rajyadhyakshan Ranade saab, they are told their presenters that ki aapke paas bahut bada bhashan hoga, par ye bhashan yahan nahi karna hai aapko, aap you can write your essay but you present your work in 15 or 20 minutes. तुम्ही फक्त 15 ते 20 मिनिटात तुमचं म्हणणं मांडा असं त्यांनी सांगितलं होतं त्यावेळेला. सो आज पण असंच आपण करतोय की 15 ते 20 मिनिटात सगळ्यांनी बोलायचं आहे आणि मग त्यानंतर वी कॅन ओपन इट फॉर डिस्कशन. हम बाद में उसका सो वी हॅव क्वाइट अ वंडरफुल लिस्ट ऑफ पीपल, यू नो. सो वी हॅव डॉक्टर विश्वनाथ शिंदे, वी हॅव रामू रामनाथन, वी हॅव अतुल पेठे, विनय शर्मा, शायरी सत्यू, Zuleka Chaudhary and Anubha Fatehpuria. these are presenters, they are going to talk, and there are, we have three moderators. Moderators are also from the field of arts, they are also scholars. So we have Sharmishta Sahab, we have Madhuri Dixit. Madhuri Dixit, so my students kept on asking me, Madhuri Dixit is coming, yes, you can come. So we have scholar, she is from Ahmednagar. She is into theatre studies. She has been working for some time now into theatres, scholarship in theatre studies. We have Sharmishta Saha. Sharmishta Saha teaches at IIT, Powai. She teaches theatre studies, literary studies, and also she is the director. And we have also Praveen Bore. Most of us know him. He is the head and professor at Lalit Kala Kendra. He is also theatre director. So they are good friends of us. So they have double responsibility because they are scholar, they are also artists. They will keep on adding into the discourse on narration in theatre, but also keep on handling our artists and scholars who are going to present. So they are moderating. So the point is this key, we'll try to keep it very informal kind of engagement, and we'll open up conversations, we'll open up debates. Bhasha Marathi pan jala kunala bolaycha asle Marathi bola mi ami translate pan karto. If you want to speak in English, yes, Hindi madhe bolaycha asle Hindi madhe pan bola kutlya pan bhashat. Mala jaast Marathi halka halka chhan vatte, but also seen the combination of the audience is mixed, so we'll keep it to English and Hindi also. So yes, I welcome all of you again. Again, I am very thankful to the trust because they are kind of helping us build a new discourse. They are helping us to extend what Ranade Sahab has done and take it to another level. So I hope we are able to take it to another level to the end of the day. So yes, we'll start. So first session, I invite Madhuri Dixit. The arrangement is that the first session we'll talk about conceptual understanding of narration in theatre. Madhuri will introduce the session. In the second session, three directors will talk, share their ideas, and in the third session, Anubha and Zuleka will share their ideas.